Hello, Vitmir. When I met Hannah Goldie, once Corey McKenna's out of the fight, and Emily Vitmir lost two last fights against Amanda Hivas and Poliana Viana via submission. Also lost to Jillian Robertson via submission at UF 26 finale. But she holds victories over Jamie Moyle, Alexandra Albu, and her stand-up game is pretty much decent. Yeah, I can say that her stand-up game simply rocks, and she has to work on a lot of other aspects of the game, like takedown defense and also grappling on the ground, wrestling on the ground. Fighting out of Hillsboro, Oregon, Syndicate MMA fighter, 5'5", 63 inches is her reach. Emily Vitmir will be looking to get back into the winning column. She's gonna meet Hannah Goldie right now, strawweight fighter. 5'4", 61 inches is Hannah Goldie's reach. And Hannah Goldie fighting out of Tampa, Florida. One of the strongest fighters in the division on the roster, but she lost to Miranda Granger and Diana Bilbita. Very hard to knock her out. She outworked Kali Robbins at Contender Series. Prior to that, she holds many decision wins. She outworked Jillian Robertson, which makes us believe that Hannah Goldie is a tough opponent. But on the other side, back-to-back losses to Miranda Granger and Diana Bilbita showed that her stand-up is critical. So if Emily Vitmir keeps this fight standing, I believe she's gonna have good chances to win the fight. Both fighters are on a losing streak, so this is the point is Emily Vitmir fought better competition lately, you know. But on the other side, Hannah Goldie is slower, but she is better on the ground, so it really depends. But if I have to pick one side, then I'm gonna go with Emily Vitmir to win this one. I think Hannah Goldie is stronger, but she is slower. She is way slower, if you know what I mean. 24K is extremely strong fighter, but she is slower, and I believe Emily Vitmir has what it takes to keep this fight standing and to outwork Hannah Goldie.